Hello and happy Easter. We come together to praise God for the miraculous resurrection of Jesus Christ. Jesus broke the barriers of sin and death so that we may live as a saved and forgiven people. Let us rejoice together as we begin our Easter worship with the call to worship, opening hymn, and opening prayer. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. We have not seen the risen Christ, but we have seen him in the faces of those transformed by grace. We have not seen Jesus face to face, but we have seen him in the faces of everyone whose love encourages us. We have not touched the wounds from the cross, but we have been called to bring healing to the scarred of the world. Let us pray together. Risen Messiah, hallelujah. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Glory be to you, whom death could not defeat. Praise to the Savior of heaven and earth. Honor and glory are yours, now and forever. Christ our Savior and Redeemer. Amen.
Good morning and happy Easter. Today is the most joyous day of the year because we know that Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive in our hearts, our minds, and in everyone that we meet. Today, that's what we celebrate as we listen to the Easter story from the Gospel of Luke. Now, last week, you remember, we saw Jesus entering into Jerusalem, where he was met by a huge crowd of people. They were all waving palm branches and singing, and they believed that Jesus would become their next king. But just a short while after that crowd had met Jesus, many of those people's attitudes about him had begun to change, and some of them were so angry that they had Jesus arrested and put on trial. and they found him guilty of crimes that he had not committed. Well, on that Friday, they took Jesus up on a hillside, and they placed him on a cross where he died. Now, there was a kind man named Joseph of Arimathea who took Jesus' body and laid it in a tomb. And then they rolled a huge rock in front of the entrance of the tomb. And a soldier was put there in front of that big rock in order to guard the tomb so that no one would touch it or come near. Now, the women who had followed Jesus throughout his ministry saw where Jesus' body had been placed, and they promised each other that they would come back in 3 days after the Sabbath in order to anoint Jesus' body. Well, imagine the women's surprise when they arrived that early Sunday morning and that soldier was no longer there. And that huge stone that had been rolled in front of the tomb had been rolled completely away, and the tomb was empty. Well, suddenly, two men dressed in bright and radiant clothing appeared. And they said to the women, "Why are you looking for the living, yes, the living, among the dead? He is not here. He is risen. Don't you remember what Jesus told you, that he would be turned over to the authorities, crucified, and then in 3 days he would rise again?" Well, immediately the women did remember, not just what Jesus had told them about his final days, but also everything that Jesus had told them while they were in Galilee and in ministry together. They remembered all of the things that Jesus had taught and what he had done. And they were so filled with joy that they ran to tell the other disciples and his other followers about all of the good news that they had seen and experienced, that they knew that Jesus was truly alive once again. And they're right. Jesus is alive in our hearts and our minds as long as we remember everything that he taught us, everything that he did, in order that we can continue to grow more Christ-like together. That's what we're celebrating today. Will you pray with me? Loving and gracious God, thank you for this joyous Easter Sunday, where we know that Jesus is alive once again, and that Jesus is with us to guide us and to help us and to let us be as good a people as we can be, because we love you and love Jesus and will follow him always. Thank you, dear God, for the miracle of Easter. Let us live with this joy today and always. Amen. Amen. Praise God for Easter morning.
Misty shadows veil the garden in the hush of early morn, and the soft, mysterious silence ushers in the day newborn. From out the dark and somber earth, spring has called. Lily, they sweetly sing. the drops of dew.
Today's scripture reading is from the Gospel of Luke, the 24th chapter, beginning with the first verse. Listen for the word of God. But on the first day of the week, at early dawn, they came to the tomb, taking the spices that they had prepared. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they went in, they did not find the body. While they were perplexed about this, suddenly two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground, but the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you, while he was still in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and be crucified, and on the third day, rise again." Then they remembered his words, and returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the other women with them who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb. Stooping and looking in, he saw the linen cloths by themselves. Then he went home, amazed at what had happened. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
This is the second year in a row we will not meet at the church for Easter. I miss seeing the large crowds, the women wearing their Easter hats, the men sporting their ties. I miss the shrieks of children hunting for Easter eggs and the clamor in the social hall after the service. For our church and most of the churches around the world, Easter is a time of celebration. It is quite a contrast to that first Easter Sunday. According to today's text, the only attendees were a group of women and two men. And it was only the men who were dressed in dazzling clothes. The women were dressed as if they were going to a funeral, which was fitting because the first Easter took place at the cemetery. The women brought with them not cookies or casseroles for the fellowship time, but spices to anoint the dead body of Jesus. It was not much of a celebration, but as the text shows, perhaps the right tone for Easter is not the somberness of the first Easter, or the joyous celebrations of today, but somewhere in between. Did you notice in today's reading, taken from the Gospel of Luke, the women never see Jesus? In Matthew, they meet him as they are leaving the tomb. In John, Mary Magdalene sees him in the tomb. And in Mark, she sees him outside the tomb. But in Luke, the women never see the risen Christ. Further, they are not told if or when they might see him again. In the other Gospels, for example, they are told to tell the other disciples he will meet them all in Galilee. But in Luke, the women are given no such promise. In Matthew, the atmosphere is charged with the extraordinary. An earthquake shakes the ground and rolls away the stone blocking the tomb's entrance. And the women see an angel descend from heaven and sit on top of it. But in Luke, the stone is rolled away already, and the women see two well-dressed men in the tomb. And that is all. And the men are not called angels. What the two men say to the women is only recorded in Luke. Why do you look for the living among the dead? We might assume they were speaking of Jesus. In fact, some manuscripts add, he is not here, but has risen. But that line is missing in some of the most reliable manuscripts. It tells us that the original verse most likely read simply, why do you look for the living among the dead? Now, the word translated as living means more than those with a pulse. It also means those who are alive in their spirit, those who've discovered life's true purpose, or, in the Apostle Paul's words, those who have discovered life's breadth and length and height and depth. It is the word Jesus used to describe the water he was offering to the Samaritan woman at the well, a woman who had been married 5 times. He used it to describe the type of bread he represented as coming down from heaven. Peter used the word to describe God. So when the men said to the women, why do you look for the living among the dead? They were saying something like, why are you looking in a cemetery for those living or seeking the deep, rich life of God? They are back in town. And Luke is the only gospel that records the two men using the word remember. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee. The word how in the sentence can also be translated as what, as may be found in the Common English Bible. Remember what he told you while he was still in Galilee. The women are told to return to their community of faith and remember what Jesus told them, not only about how he was to die, but how they were to live, to heal the sick, cast out demons, love their enemies, and announce the reign of God. It is in returning to their faith community and continuing Jesus' ministry that they will see him, for he will be in the midst of them, not in bodily form, but in spirit, guiding, comforting, challenging, and strengthening them. Thus, the true meaning of Easter is, okay, now it's your turn. Jesus revealed to us the one true living God, whose will it is that we be perfected in sacrificial love. He sends us to apply this love to a hurting world, unafraid of giving ourselves completely to this task. For whatever may befall us, like Jesus, we will rise again. He may not be physically around to lead us, but he left behind his instructions and is with us in spirit. That's all the women needed to hear on that first Easter Sunday. They remembered Jesus' words, left their spices at the tomb, and returned to their community of faith to tell the others, it's time to roll up your sleeves. We have work to do. And that is the true Easter celebration. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, who raised our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead, we thank you for the sign of your approval, that Jesus is your beloved, and we should listen to him. We thank you for your word delivered through your prophets, and finding its full expression in Jesus. We thank you for restoring our relationship to you through the sacrifice of Jesus. We ask for your courage to take his yoke upon us, that we may continue his ministry as his disciples. Grant us the selfsame power to heal, to defeat demons, to welcome sinners, and bring good news to the poor, as you gave to him. And let us not be afraid of being rejected, knowing that is the way the prophets and Jesus were treated. We praise you for the hope you have given us by raising Christ from the dead. We no longer need to fear death, for death has been overcome. We praise you for the Spirit you give to us that guides, comforts, and encourages us as we carry on the ministry of Jesus. We praise you for affirming life over death and for calling us to proclaim this. These things we pray in the name of the risen one, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us continue in prayer by praying the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Today, I know that he is near.
Thank you for joining us on this joyous Easter Sunday. We are so glad that we can worship God together. Please plan to join us again in the coming weeks. Hear now this blessing. May the loving power of God, which raised Jesus into new life, strengthen you with hope, enrich you in love, and fill you with joy for your faith life ahead. God bless you on this Easter day, now and always. Amen.